Pseudoephedrine is one of the main ingredients in making methamphetamine, and some agencies want it off the shelves. But many are discussing whether this issue is a law enforcement situation only, or if it should affect the medical field as well. News 10's Sarah Schaefer has more.
In 2013, one box of pseudoephedrine was sold about every 15 seconds. That's according to officials with the Indiana State Police. They're one of the agencies in the group known as Indiana's Coalition Against Meth-Making Meds. Along with them, the mayor of Terre Haute.
Is a coalition of multiple groups across the state of Indiana that want to encourage the legislature to make this change, make it a prescription med so that we can fight the meth problem that we have in Indiana.
Taking the medicine off the shelves would return it to its 1976 status of a level 3 controlled substance, meaning you could only get it with a prescription. And Bennett says those who support this change have seen firsthand what it's like without a prescription.
Right now we're focused on that law enforcement side, that public safety, that official side, because we know what it's doing to the system.
So what do health officials think? Well, former health commissioner of Indiana says, quote, "We don't have to make life more difficult for patients and their families to make progress in the battle against meth."
I think as physicians and other healthcare providers, we believe that this is a law enforcement issue and not a medical issue that should be solved by disrupting the medical healthcare system and inconveniencing thousands and thousands of patients that safely use pseudoephedrine.
Feldman is a member of the Indiana Stop Meth, Not Meds Coalition. He believes pseudoephedrine should remain available without a prescription, and law enforcement should remain a top priority. Both groups agree meth is a serious problem in Indiana, but disagree on what to do in hopes of fixing it. In Terre Haute, I'm Sarah Schaefer, News 10.
For more information on both of these groups, you can visit our website. That's WTHITV.com.